Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Easy Electrical. In previous lecture I have discussed the end condenser method of medium transmission line. Now I am going to discuss the nominal T method for the medium transmission line, and I will draw the figure and after that I will draw the phasor diagram. I hope this lecture helps and it will be beneficial to you. So first of all, let me draw the circuit diagram for the medium transmission line. The method is nominal T method. Here the simple figure is drawn. It is just the T shape that you can see. Here that, and during analysis we need to consider the some sending end voltage Vs. This is Is. Suppose this is considering to be R by 2. This is we can consider XL by 2. So this one it will come like this, Z1 by 2, something like that. It will come. Similarly, this is R by 2. This is also XL by 2. So this is also, this will also be Z1 by 2. Suppose this is any capacitance C. The current here is IC. In this direction the current is IS. In this direction the current is IR. Considering the voltage in this point to be V. Suppose V1 I am just saying. Here the voltage is what it is, VR. We all know. This is our load. So this is the basic figure of our nominal T circuit diagram of medium transmission line. Now when we have to draw the phasor diagram, then again we have to start from the receiving end side. Here the voltage, what it is, VR, we need to consider as this. What is current? IR. This current we all know that we are considering for the for simple cases it is a, what it is, it is a lagging in nature current. This current is lagging in nature. So first of all, I need to draw VR. So this is my VR. If this is VR, suppose I am drawing in this direction, this is IR. This is IR. So if in this direction it is VR and the current is IR, then IC will be in this direction, we all know. It will be 90 degrees to IR. From that, we can observe one another thing. If we add the two, we will get, electrically if we add the two, we will get what it is, IS. We will obtain IS. Now similarly, here one thing you can observe that there are two types of voltage drops available. One voltage drop is because of IR into R by 2 and IR into XL by 2. So first of all, I need to draw parallel voltages of IR into R by 2 like this. Maintaining IR in this direction, we will have IR into R by 2, something like this, and in the 90 degrees direction, we will have IR into XL by 2 draw. I think you all know, and you, from now on, you now can observe, you all know that through any resistance, voltage and current are in same phase, and for an inductor, current or voltage is leading. Current is in this direction, so voltage will be leading by 90 degrees. You can observe from here. Now, if I add these two vectors, if I add, what we will obtain? I will reach up to this point. Up to this point means up to this voltage, that is V1. So, if I just add the two, what I have obtained? This summation will give me what? This summation will give me V1. What is V1? V1 is the voltage across this point. It will give me this voltage. Now after this, I am coming to this side. Up to this part, I have obtained. Up to V1, I have obtained. Now from V1, if you see, there is another drop IS into R by 2 and IS into XL by 2. Now we have to explain, or we have to put forward in the figure, what is IS into R by 2 and what is IS into XL by 2. So maintaining IS, IS was marked in red color. This was our IS. So maintaining IS, a parallel figure needs to be drawn. That is this IS into R by 2, the drop. And maintaining 90 degrees to that, maintaining 92 degrees to that, something like that will be drawn, IS into XL by 2. Because this drop we need to take care, that will be, the voltage drop will be leading the current. Now if I add the 2, what I get? I get my VS. Now from this figure you can observe this difference of IS and VS, we call it as angle phi S, and the angle for VR and IR we call it as phi R. Simple or not? So similarly, in this way you can observe how I have drawn the phasor diagram. And in this, another two considerations we can take, that is this part is basically what it is. We can like IR into Z1 by 2. Here Z1 I have taken. Let it be Z1 by 2. I can write like this. Here also I can write the same thing. But the current will be different. What will be the current? IS into Z1 by 2. Z1 by 2. I hope this discussion on phasor diagrams is clearing all the concepts, all the misunderstandings, and how to draw a phasor diagram you are getting cleared. From this figure, from where to start is the main important point while drawing the phasor diagram. We need to draw from the receiving end. If we start from the receiving end and go slowly come towards this VS, we will ultimately obtain this value. Now, if I want to do some calculations here, what I will do? First of all, I need to know that IS is what it is. We all know IC plus IR. This is very, very simple. Similar to the other problem, that is in the case of end condenser method, the same explanation for IS. Now here another term comes, that is V1. Here the voltage across IC is basically V1. V1 can be expressed like that also. Another way we can express also, that is V1 we can write like this. VR plus what it is? IR into Z1 by 2. Similarly, like this, we can also obtain VS. What is VS? VS is basically V1 plus IS into Z1 by 2. Very, very easy. In this way, you can correctly observe all the things. Here, what is VR? VR as a vector, as we have taken it as reference, it is VR at an angle 0 degrees. And IR, what will be IR? If IR is the vector, IR vector is basically IR and cos phi R minus j sin phi R. For voltage, the same formula applies, but here the angle for voltage was 0. That is why if we want to get the magnitude form, it will only come out to be VR. In the other, in end condenser method, I have shown how it is coming out to be VR. Now, if we put these values here, we can correctly obtain in any form. We can go by rectangular form, or we can go by polar form. In these two approaches, any one approach you can apply. First of all, I prefer this rectangular form of approach, or in some cases, polar form of approach may be applied. These are very simple terms. Now just put the values, whatever you have obtained, in any one form, not mixed form, any one form. Suppose this is the polar form, you are putting the polar form here also. So likewise, you can obtain the sending end voltage, sending end current, what is V1, you can obtain. And similarly, from here also, you can write the percentage voltage regulation. The voltage regulation will always remain the same. VS minus VR by VR into 100%. And also, transmission efficiency will also remain the same, that is output power by input power, output by input power into 100%. That is power, in terms of power, in terms of power. So similarly, in this way we can correctly get what is nominal T method, what is its circuit diagram, what is its phasor diagram, what are the relationships between different vector quantities. From this discussion, I hope you have understood the basics of what is nominal T method, what is its figure, what is its phasor diagram, what are the simple notations, what are the simple representations. Here you can simply just see one thing. This is the current, this is the load, you are multiplying the current and plus this voltage, you will getting this, you will be getting this. Similarly, this voltage and this voltage drop, if you add, you will be getting this. Just this simple point, if you remember, you will be able to solve any problem related to nominal T method, in conventional method, or even nominal pi method. That will be sufficient for you. Thank you everyone. I hope this lecture helps, and please go through the lecture once again. And after after this lecture, I will post some mathematical problems, and during that mathematics, you will have a better idea. Thank you everyone.